Hello everyone, this is me, Gennard. I want to show you how to fix an NTLDR missing. So you can see my monitor here, it says NTLDR missing, press Ctrl Alt Delete to restart. Now of course you cannot use your computer if you are running Windows XP. This is a common problem with Windows XP. Okay, you cannot continue to use your computer, it just appears like that. If you are going to press Ctrl Alt Delete, it continues to restart and will give you the same kind of error. So this kind of error is often caused by a corrupted NTLDR, or maybe it is caused by a virus wherein the virus actually deleted that kind of file within the system. Now there are actually a lot of ways you can do, or let's say you can find over the internet, but what I'm going to do right now is the easiest way and most possible the safest way to resolve this kind of problem. Okay, so for those who are also taking up the computer technician course, or maybe you are reviewing for your NC2, this is one of course of the questions that will arise there, and a lot of students, they just memorize this one, they go out in the real world, they do not know how to do it because they didn't even know how it goes. They just memorize the solution on how to fix this one. So I'm going to show you that right now. Okay, so first of all, you need to have your CD. This one, I have my CD here. I have an external drive, but of course if you have some built-in optical drive, you can use that one. For my case, I'm going to use this one. So you need to have a operating system like mine, Windows XP. We are going to use the repair. So the error here was actually with the operating system installed. We are going to copy the NTLDR coming from this disk going to our drive, dun sa hard disk, okay? So if you can read that one, it says NTLDR missing, press Ctrl Alt Delete to restart. So I'm going to press my Ctrl Alt Delete. Now I'm going to go for my BIOS. I'm going to make sure that my boot startup will be going for my CD. So I'm going to go there. Okay, check. If you try to see it here, you cannot see that one. It's too bright. I'm going to check if my... Where are you? Oh, let me find it first. Nothing. Okay. Ano na lang. Okay, if you try to see it here, we have both. First boot is my USB slim type, meaning this one. My second boot is your SATA, wherein that is my hard drive. So I'm going to boot from my USB slim type. That is my disk here, this one. Okay, I'm going to boot there. And then right now, I'm going to save that one. I'm going to press F10. Okay, I just checked if that is working well. Okay, or it was set up very well. So there we go. Save configuration, changes, and exit setup. Okay, that's what I want. Okay, so we're going to wait for that one to boot up. Okay, so this one, I'll press any key to boot from CD. So that's it, it's booting from my CD, so that we're just going to try to check if, we're going to repair that one. We're going to wait for at least a couple of minutes here. It will load up the installer, or what we call the operating system, from the disk. Alright, so we are here again. So if you can see, it says here, setup is starting Windows, it will black out, it will show us something. So we can see here, we are going to use this one. To repair a Windows XP installation using Recovery Console, we are going to press R. So that's what we need right now. So I'm going to press my R here on my keyboard, R, there we go. And this is going to try to read where our operating system was installed. So we have a operating system on D, wherein we are going to press the number here. So which Windows installation would you like to log on to? Okay, we want to log on to your one, your D Windows, because we only have one operating system here. So if you have more than one operating system and one drive, you can see it there, a couple of them listed down. Okay, so I'm going to press one and then press enter. So I'm going to press enter. Okay, type the administrator password. In this case, I know that this computer has no password, so I'm not going to write one. But if you have, you should put the password. Okay, so I'm actually with Windows. Now, what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to go to my disk here. I'm going to go there, try to check if my NTLDR is there, but I already know that it is there, but I want to show you, because we are not going to be able to be here if we do not have the NTLDR with our disk with here. So I know that this is the drive we'll call G, so I'm going to go to G. This drive letter of this one is G, because I know I have four drives with this computer. I have C, D, E, F, and the fifth one, this will be my G. So I'm going to go to G. Now, here G, we are going to see if my NTLDR, or let's say I'm going to find where it is located. So I'm going to use the command dir. Okay, I'm going to see it here. Okay, if you can see it here, we have I386. I'm going to go inside I386 to see if my NTLDR is there. So CD, that is a command to change directory, I386. Okay, now I'm inside I386. I want to see what is inside I386, so I'm going to dial again DIR, or what we call directory, DIR. So here we have a bunch of files there. We are going to use the space to scroll down. We are going to see down. We are going to see the NTLDR wherein that is M, and that's M. Okay, so we will be having there you go. We have NTLDR. This is the file missing on our disk. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to copy NTLDR, put it into my C drive, because that is the place it should be, where it was corrupted or it was missing. It was deleted by some sort of malware, I guess. So I'm going to escape, we stop, and then what I'm going to do is copy, let's say, you're going to see there down below. I'm not sure if that's clear. Okay, let's make it closer. Okay, there you go. So I'm going to type copy space. The name of the file that I'm going to copy is NTLDR, and then space where I'm going to place the NTLDR. So I'm going to place this one on C. So I'm going to put C. That is the directory I want to put on C. Hold on. Okay, and I'm going to press enter. Enter. Okay, to get a moment to copy that one. Okay, so if you can try to see that one file is copied. So I want to check if it really went into my C. So I'm going to go to C. I'm going to change directory C. There you go. Oops, that should be on. Okay, and then there you go. So I'm already on C. My directory changed to C. And then I'm going to check if my NTLDR there is already copied. DIR again, directory. Okay, and then there you go. Let's try C. Okay, there you go. We have NTLDR copied with our C. So the last thing we're going to do is we are going to restart and try to boot from our drive or CD drive. No, not our CD drive. Our hard drive, to check if it will boot up properly. So I'm going to type exit, and there you go. It will actually restart. Okay. And then I'm going to go to my BIOS again, change the boot configuration. Since it is booting from my slim type, I'm going to change that one. It will be my SATA, where that is my drive. So if you can check that one. And then I'm going to press F10 here. F10, there you go, to save the configuration. Right, see that one there. Okay.
save configuration, changes, and exit setup. Okay, so let's try to see. It should be booting up with Windows. Okay. And then, kaboom! There you go! I told you! Okay, thank you for watching. We have more videos to come. I'll be covering also a lot of problems regarding computers. And most especially, I know a lot of people would like to know about laptops also. I'll be covering laptop repair, not only the basics one, okay? I'll be covering, troubleshooting the motherboard, fixing the motherboard, a dead laptop, something like those ones. And I'm going to show you a lot more things about computers. Okay, so thank you for watching. See you again next time. Goodbye.